Whoa. Deep breath here. All right.
We're in set. We'll let Coach open with a statement, and then we'll go to questions.
Clearly, we weren't prepared to play today. Thought we took about 97 steps backwards. I thought we've had three really good weeks of preparation with energy, toughness. And for whatever reason, we just didn't have it today. We couldn't guard. We missed shots. We couldn't screen. Credit Butler. Butler came in here. We're a desperate team. Lost three in a row. Lost a couple of tough ones on the road. Played in hostile situations. I appreciate the crowd for coming out and support that. We just weren't ready to play. Clearly, I didn't do a very good job in the preparation of Butler, given it was the second time we played him. Right? So, got to support our guys. We gave them tomorrow off. We got another road game coming up in a hostile situation. But, we'll put this one behind us. I won't watch one clip of this. And this is part of the process of going through, development. Right? But we're not going to sit up here and complain and point fingers. If all the fingers should be pointed at me, all the daggers should be pointed at me. Clearly, I did not do a good job preparing our group for how hungry Butler was to come into our building and play. They beat us at every facet of the game, especially the physical part. And that's the most disappointing to me. I can deal with, a loss here or there. But when somebody physically comes in and overwhelms you, right, that's something that we just have to address. Other than that, let's keep building. Let's stay positive with one another. And let's keep moving forward. Hopefully, we collectively can do a better job to try to get our next win.
Start with Patrick Stevens from the Post.
And starting at the defensive end in the first half, it seemed like they were just able to kind of get whatever they wanted, whether it was inside or outside. Some of that's obviously kind of an issue with this whole season. How much worse was it tonight, you feel like, than maybe on
this is the worst we've played all year. I mean, I think this is worse than the game we played at Marquette. We're playing at home. They're playing at home. The energy, the level of respect that I have for our crowd, our supporters, our students, the university, for us to have a piss poor performance that way, knowing we've been away from this building for a couple of weeks, to come in and have that shown is just disappointing as the coach. And clearly we have some issues defensively. It's not like you can, have mid-semester trades and, you're trading players. Our players came here for an opportunity to play. And that's what we'll hold them accountable to. We got to get better. Clearly, our defense is absolutely atrocious right now, and that's on me. And I gotta fix it because there's, Pat Ewing and Mutombo, as Tino says, they ain't coming through that door.
As at the offensive end, it's that second half was maybe as significant an unraveling as you guys had as well. I think it was 2 of 19 at one point. Mm-hmm. Was that more surprising in a lot of ways? And do you feel like when that goes downhill a little bit, you maybe have a guy or two that's looking, in particular Jaden, that's looking to maybe do a little too much?
I didn't think Jaden tried to do too much. I thought he had some good shots. He had three shots in one possession, and all of them were open shots. We're going to talk about this here. You'll know you start building an incredible team when the ball's not going in and you're getting down to the last 2 or 3 minutes of a game and have a chance to win. That's what are we hanging our hat on right now, right? Great teams hang their hat on toughness, defense, continuity, teamwork. That's called a culture that we're not there yet, right? So we got frustrated when the ball wasn't going in the basket. So our offensive energy gave us defensive energy at some point. And when it's not going in there, we just didn't look well.
It's to that point, it seemed like there were spurts tonight where you just settle for threes. And how much is that hurting you defensively, and how much is that hurting you on the offensive end?
I think our floor balance, when you're taking all them threes, right? This is the most threes one of my teams have ever taken over the course of this year up to this point, right? And we're trying to get the ball inside more. I mean, Supreme continues to develop. I think he's getting better and better each and every game. But some of the layups we missed early, those deteriorating. Some of the design sets we have that open shots are deteriorating. We had some loose ball turnovers. We couldn't come up with a 50-50 ball. So that all plays into the emotion of people, especially young teams that are, learning to come together. But the excuse of us being young, and we've been together since, April or June. We should be better. We should be better, and I thought we turned a corner. Unfortunately, it's disappointing because we went backwards.
I know you talked about the lack of physicality. At one point, they almost had 50% of their points in the paint. It seemed like they were willing to post up any of you guys. Mm-hmm. Is there something schematically that can be done that can kind of mitigate that.
Again, we were trapping in there a couple of times, and, you know, again, you got to give them a lot of credit. I mean, they played well. They played big boy basketball, and Georgetown clearly didn't put up a big boy fight.
Compared to last game, did they try to hit the paint more so this time around?
It looks like that, yeah. It definitely did. It definitely looked they had a heavy concentration on trying to play in front of the rim. You know, we were doing some switching, then we didn't switch. And then we couldn't capitalize coming out of, you know, the first 4 minutes of the second half, where we missed a couple of layups, missed a couple of open shots. We traded baskets to and from and just couldn't get any rhythm.
Horrible game, but like Bristol's energy, is that something that you can point to positively?
I can't point to one positive thing Georgetown did today, not one, other than we put on an incredibly nice-looking uniform, and we had a great bus ride over, we had an incredible pregame meal, and everybody's still on scholarship. That's about the only goddamn thing we did well today.
Gotcha. You keep saying that, you know, you want to take all the blame, take the daggers, that type of stuff.
That's what leaders do.
Exactly. What do you hope to see from your team in a bounce back situation in a very hostile environment that you know you're going to see on Saturday in a familiar spot for you?
Well, we're excited about that. You know, it'll be a lot to be said about how we respond, right? How we respond. And I think our players have responded pretty decent on the road, right? Your question, I don't remember what your question was. What was your question?
Just that you always post-game, whether we watch it on Zoom or we're in here with you, you want to take all the blame. Come at me, it's my fault, I didn't prepare them.
Yeah.
But what do you want to see from your players in
I
the
want
next
us
game?
To fight, meaning play with a sense of urgency, play with a sense of teamwork, play with a sense of pride, care, understanding, playing for, you know, the name on the front of your shirt, you know what I mean? Like, again, it's frustrating. It's frustrating playing at home, when you lose. This is our home court. It's our home crowd. These are people that love us and support us. And I can't tell you how grateful I am to the fans, to our students that come out to support us, right? We're just not there yet. As much as we want to get there, it's the pain of process. It's the pain of development. And all I can tell you is we're going to do a great job in our preparation for Providence. That's our next game. It's a game everybody will talk about. It's another Big East game that we're excited to play.
Coach, Butler put up 90 points. How much of this defensive breakdown do you attribute to a lack of communication on your side?
A lot. I appreciate your question, and I think that's one of our weaknesses. We've got to do a better job communicating. We've got to do a much better job. Back-to-back games, we've given up 90 points. I don't think we've had a Big East game where we've held somebody under 50%, and particularly from twos. They were 27 for 42 from two today. Right? That's almost being in a gym by yourself. So it's a character check. It's a team check. It's a mirror check. It's a coaching check. It's an organizational check, right? But you know what? We're going to be okay. It's all right. We're going to be okay. There are days where it just don't go in the basket. There are days where it's just not your day. Today wasn't our day. But over the course of time, hopefully we can get better.
And you guys held Brooks kind of in check when you guys were at Hankleton, and he gets on that heater in the first half. You know, what sort of challenges did he provide you guys in the first half?
Well, I think he's made the most threes in conference play. We talked about that. We lost him. I think he had 16 or 18 in the first half. So, you know, we got to concentrate a little bit better. But he got them off to an incredible start. Really, really good start. Really good start. And that's a lack of awareness and alertness on our behalf. We went over it in a scout. You know, I thought we had three decent days of preparation. We cut our practice time down to, you know, preserve our bodies. The time of the year, you got to do a really good job preserving your men's body. But, you know, credit him. You know, anytime you see the bank shot go in, you're like, ooh, that's not that one there, boy. You know, it's just, if you coached enough games, you're going to see, man, ooh, I don't know if it's going to be our day if one of them shots going in.
And next up, you guys go to Providence, a place that obviously we know the surrounding story. You're focused on the 40 minutes on the court, but your thoughts as you go back to a place that was so kind to you and you were so kind to over the years?
Yeah, it's let's call it what it is. It'll be an emotional time for all of us, my family, you know, but it's going to be an opportunity for us. You know, I'll appreciate the opportunity I had there for 12 years. Incredible school, incredible leadership there. They have a great team. But time passes, you move on. It'll be a little emotional until the ball goes up, and then once the ball goes up, it's another Big East game. Like, if you do not prepare, and you're emotionally, physically, and ready to play in the Big East, these are the things that happen. The power of the Big East is amazing. you know, and that'll be another really tough road, Big East game. It just happens to be the place that I coach, happened to be the place where I grew up. Appreciate the time there, but it's different time, different era, different team. Time to keep moving forward. Thanks.
Thank you, everyone.